my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to give you my final review on the newest palette from Nomad Cosmetics called Whistler Snow Lodge. It's a two-part review. The first part went online yesterday, which was me creating 5 looks to give you inspiration and to show you how the shadows performed while you were doing a makeup look. And today I'm going to give you eye swatches. And at the end of that, I will give you my final judgment on this palette and some tips and tricks. Welcome to the best bucking lodge in Whistler, BC, an epic destination where best in snow mountains provide an unsurpassing playground that make any skier want to keep coming back. And for those who don't give a fox about hitting the slopes, there's plenty to do in the chill yet vibrant Whistler village where après anything is everything. And our favorite part is that this very cool destination is super environmentally friendly as well. So come share you amusing stories of the day as you enjoy your stay at the Nomad Lodge Whistler. The palette is vegan and cruelty free, and on the back of the palette you will also get the shade names. You get the inspiration. The ingredients are on the box on the I have to look. They're on the box on the side. It is their normal layout, so you get a mirror, you get 3, 6, 9, 12, you get 15 shades. It's a combination of shimmers, mattes and 2 duochromes. Yes, the look that I have on my eyes today is the last look of the video of yesterday that will be linked underneath the card. For now though, I am going to prep my eyelids for the eye swatching portion of the video. For now, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up and enjoy, because here, welcome the eye swatches. The first shade is the shade Ski In. No glitter primer, no nothing, and it is dry. Very nice. I'm going to spray it so you can see the difference. A little bit more intense. This is a very, very smooth shade. And very pretty. The shade Ski In. And for the shimmers, I am using a Jessup 233 cream shader and a Zoeva 233 cream shader. And for the mattes, I am using a packing brush from Nabla from the Amethyst set, this one, and an MSQ packing brush. And I also have Sigma in case I want to. Next shade is going to be the shade Apreski. And I'm using the Natasha Denona eye base right now. I don't know how much I have left though. This is a very, very nice minty. It blends out very, very well. I won't blend too much because we have a lot of shades to go. Here's the shade called Apreski. Let me clean the eyes, and I clean my eyes with some micellar water, then I clean that off with a little bit of water, and then an eye cream goes on top, and then a primer. So that's the prep that I'm doing, and that's kind of to protect my eyelids, so let me do that. First one is the shade called Snow Bunny, and it is a matte. It's a pale baby blue. I do have to build this one up, but when I used it in the look, it was better because my eye wasn't as dry. My primer was a little bit more sticky. Because this is a pastel, it benefits from a sticky primer. Yeah, I did not really apply my primer correctly, but so that's why it's looking patchy. And the multiple looks video will be linked down below underneath the cards. Next shade is going to be the shade Powder Specialist. I'm going to apply it dry and then show you what it looks like sprayed. Well, now I'm going to spray it. Don't overspray this one if you're spraying your shimmers. Because it's a delicate shade. I don't know how it behaves on top of a glitter primer. Because I don't use glitter primers. But here is the shade Powder Specialist. I need to switch to a different primer, one that's a little bit more wet, hydrating than the Natasha Denona one. So I'm actually switching to one from Catrice. Because it has a base shade. But I need the hydration. Next shade I'm going to use is the shade For Fox Sake, which is a brick red matte. Very, very pretty brick red shade that, depending on the base that you wear it on, because the base that I have on right now is pretty pink. And the Natasha Denona base is more orangey, so on me this one pulls in a little bit of the pinkerness of the red instead of turning more into a brick red. Very pretty shade though. The next shade that I'm going to do on the other eye is a shimmer called Berry Cool. Let's try first. Very, very sparkly. Okay, let's spray it. And when I spray, I pick up shadow on the brush and then I spray the brush. And there is two reasons for that. One, fallout. You minimize the fallout that way. And you make some shades more intense. Sometimes it doesn't matter, but sometimes it does. So you just have to experiment with that. But here it is, the shade Bare Equal. Next shade is shade Whistler, which is a shimmer. So dry. I almost don't think that I need to spray this one, but I will. Oh, it's such a stunning shade. Shade Whistler. Whistler. The next shade is going to be the shade Snowmad. If I can find my brush. And Snowmad is a dark blue matte. This one is pretty, all the mattes are pretty pigmented and they do blend out very, very well. But if I go blending now, my eyelids will hate me. So if you want to see how they perform, you need to go watch yesterday's video, which will be linked underneath the cards. Shade Snowmad. Next shade is, well, I have two shimmers actually. The next shade is the shade Blackcomb, which is a blue shimmer. A dark blue shimmer. It is a little bit particly, so I do have fallout, but it's a stunning shade. Yes, I know, I don't like blues. It's just very, very sparkly. I think it's a pretty blue. Let's spray it. But because of the sparkly bits, it is a little bit fallouty. So just keep that in mind. But if you look, this benefits from spraying because it gets more even, almost a little bit more sparkly. They stick together well. Shade Blackcomb. Next shade is another shimmer. It's the shade Up to Snowgood. Okay, this was dry. Let's spray it. The shade gets a little bit more sticky when you spray it, or at least with this brush, but intense wise, I don't feel like it really, really matters. It's a smooth shade, very, very pretty. Here's the shade Up to Snowgood. Next shade is the shade Gone Skiing, and it's a very, I thought it was a very cool toned brown, but it's actually not. It's more along the lines of a neutral dark brown, or maybe even a yellow tone dark brown. At the end of this video, I will also compare swatch. So I will swatch this one to, I think it was one from the Haunted Europe palette. This one is very, very pigmented. So here's the shade Gone Skiing. It's a stunning shade, honestly. And the next color is the shade Bucking Great, which is a very dark green. Also very, very pigmented. So how did I use this shade in the look? I actually started with the lighter green and lightly set my eyeshadow base with that. And then I built this one on top, and then the blending went just a little bit easier. You know, I have older eyelids. I don't want to blend more than I need to, because movement, you know, it's kind of like in your panties. elastic bands kind of, you know, they lose their stretch. And that's with eyelids the same thing. So if I blend too much, my eyelids will not thank me. But yeah, here is the shade called Bucking Great. A stunning shade. Next, I have two shimmers and one of them is a duochrome. So the last duochrome is called Ski Bum. So let's do it dry first. My base is still sticky though. I'm going to spray it. Then you just get different colored shifts, you know. You can put this on top of the light blue matte, or dark blue matte, the black matte on its own, on top of the green, the red, just whatever floats your boat. But now it's breaking up a bit. I can see that's not good. Is that my eye? Or is it a brush? Let me get a clean brush that's truly, truly clean. And let me try it again. Because I think I sprayed it also in the look. So maybe it's my eye. Let's see. Or it's the brush. Could be. Yeah, I think it's a combination of my eye and the brush, honestly. I don't know. Can you see the shift? It's a mess right now. I'm well aware. But I can see a teal. You can just, I think you can only see a blue. What? I think you can see it a little bit better on my finger right now, what it's doing. And I can see that on my eye, but I don't know if it translates on camera. So there is that, but it is there. So I think my brush is just done. So the next shade I'm going to use is the last shimmer of the palette, and it's called So Amused. And it's a gorgeous, gorgeous brown, which also has different colored sparklies in it. So no shifts. But the sparkly that is in it has a different color. And I actually saw that when I did the look. I could tell there are multi-colored sparkles in them. Such a stunning shade. So amused. Okay, I have one shade left and that's the black. So let me clean one eye. Okay, let's go to the black called Ski Out. That's the last shade of the palette. Let's see if my eye will want to play nice. It's a very nice and pigmented black. It's a very easy black to work with. So if you go in a little bit slower, you can just use it to darken up a look. But as you can see, if you pack it on your eye, well, you can do that too. Shade Ski Out. Okay, okay. So those were the eye swatches and also my thoughts during the eye swatches. What is most important though is how do they perform during a makeup look? Because packing on is all well and dandy, but how do they perform? And I have thoughts. Their formula in the past was very soft, very blendable, but not necessarily very buildable. Very beginner friendly though, and always very nice and pigmented. So, and the shimmers were always stunning as well. They have kind of started reformulating their palettes or their eyeshadows a little bit. And that started with the Fire and Ice palette. They are focusing a little bit more on buildability. That unfortunately takes away from the blendability, but they're still very blendable. You can layer them a lot better than their previous formula. So that is kind of a little bit on the background of the reformulation. If you have some of their older palettes and then get this one, you will notice a difference. So is that a bad thing? Not at all, but then you kind of know what to expect, you know? Let's go over everything. So let's start with the mattes. I think that the mattes are very nice and pigmented. They are, as I said, more pigmented even than their older formula, especially because there are cooler tones in here that makes me need to work with, or want to work with them a little bit differently. So in the first look, you saw me just basically packing on this brown and then trying to blend it out. It went a little bit patchy because I was over blending. That is the combination of the pigmentation of this shade and the fact that it is a tad drier than their old formula, which focused more on blendability. So knowing that, the next looks I build up differently. So what do I do with a formula like this? that is very pigmented, which in the eyeshadows are a lot of the time. I actually like to kind of set my base a little bit, but not necessarily with a face powder. So if I, for instance, what I did in the second look when I did the green, I kind of set my eyeshadow base a little bit with this green already. Very, very lightly, and then I can still build on top of it. Because if you set it very, very heavily, you can still build, but it won't be as intense as if you still can use the stickiness and the grip of the primer, if that makes any sense. So where do I like to blend? I like to blend a little bit, or I like to set a little bit higher. So basically you see the edge here of the eyeshadow. That is kind of where I want to have a little bit of a set layer, so that I can blend easier and that I don't have to blend as much. It's probably my skill set though, I think at least, because I am teaching myself how to build or pack color on and then blend it out a little bit instead of what I usually do, kind of set my eyeshadow base a little bit and then build on top of that. This formula, it can do both, but I feel it works better if you set your base a hint, at least where you want to blend. It just makes it easier, especially on me with older eyelids, where if I go to blend, you can kind of see that that's going to skip. It's just the nature of how my eyelids are. So if you don't have that, you probably won't get that skipping and such, I think at least. So this is a pretty cool toned palette again, right? There are, even though there are warmer shades in here like the red, it's still kind of a cooler tone. And I think that's very, very fun. I think it's very different now that the warmer palettes are basically making a comeback again. I like the fact that they still, even though they put in warmer shades, still kind of keep them on the cooler side a little bit. Yeah, so those were the mattes. They showed up very, very well for me. They were easy to manipulate. And yeah, they built very, very well. I do want to touch on the black as well, because I think that this is a very, very nice black. The shadows are a little bit kick-up-y. If you use a brush that is a little bit more open, and I also use a combination of real hair brushes and synthetic brushes. With real hair brushes, if the hairs are a little bit stiffer, you just push a little bit more into the product and it creates a little bit of kick up. So just so you know, tap off your brush if you're doing your eyes first, because you can create fallout. The black is a very, very nice black. I think it's one of my favorite. They do blacks very, very well. What can I say? This is a black that I really, really like because it still has the pigment, but it's still easy and safe to work with. So it's not like you put it on your eye and you have to keep on building it, or that you put it on your eye and you're like, damn it, where do I blend that black out to? So I always start slow with a black, but if you are the type of person that packs on a black, you can use this one very, very well, and it's still then easy to blend out. Yes, those are the mattes. Let's go to the shimmers. Let's go to the two duochromes that are in here, which is Powder Specialist and Ski Bunny. Let's start with Powder Specialist. It's not my favorite shade. I think the name is spot on, Powder Specialist. I feel it's pretty powdery. Now, it is a white base, but I feel it's a powdery one. When I put it in my inner corner, it is, for me personally, a little bit too lackluster. That's why I wanted to use it on my eyelids in the look today, because I wanted to know how it performs. Now, I don't know if it is the nature of a duochrome with a white base, because I have a few, and a lot of them kind of feel a little bit powdery to me, at least. I could get it to work, but I do feel that this particular shade will benefit from either a glitter primer, or as I did, spraying your brush. You can use it with a finger, but I'm not a fan of that. So yeah, out of the entire palette, this is actually my least favorite shade, because I would have wished it to have a little bit more binder, a little bit more creaminess in it. But again, it could be the nature of the shade. I am not versed enough in multi-chromes or duochromes with lighter base, well, any in particular, that I can really attest to that this is normal or it's just this particular shade. For me personally, I felt it was a little bit dry and powdery. Then the shade Ski Bum. I think it's a very, very fun, very, very fun, pretty shade. And this one has more substance to it. So where the Powder Specialist has that powderiness in it, I feel that this one doesn't. And I like the fact that you can really use it to transform the other shades if you want to. It is intense enough to put in my inner corner, or you know, here in the inner part, which I really like. I do like this one as a highlighter, by the way. I have used it as a highlighter in the video. So yeah, out of the two duochromes, I like this one the best. The other shades though, if I look here at the shade Blackcomb, it is a dark blue, but it also has a little bit of this red in it. Same with the green. The green, they are not duochromes, but they have a little something extra in them. Same with So Amused. When I had this one on and the combination of what I did, it looks like kind of a caramelly, chocolatey brown. But there's also a hint of this shade in it again, and a hint of this shade in it. So, and they do that a lot. So while they're then not duochromes, there is, if you look closely, kind of a almost a multicolored sparkle in them. And I think that that is so, so nice. This green, I love this green because it does not turn yellow on me. Maybe I need to explain that I am an olive, and if I put any like colors like these on me, turn yellowy very, very quickly, because my face just eats up the green, and it didn't. Same with this, it stayed nice and minty. So overall, I think that the quality is very, very nice. As I said, if you feel that your eyeshadow is getting patchy, especially, I actually had it especially with this darker brown, go in a little bit differently. So start with a bigger fluffy brush and put your first layer down gently. That saves blending, and then build on top of that. That's how I tackled the looks. And I had a lot of fun creating the looks. So yeah, the shadows stayed on my eyes all day. I did not notice any fading. Now, I'm not someone who wants to have their makeup on for 18 hours. So my day starts at, I don't know, 9 o'clock in the morning or something like that when I'm finished with my makeup, and ends at 9 o'clock at night. Something like that, so maybe 12 hours. I did not have any fading. I did not have any creasing either. And that is because these shimmers, while they are very, very nice and shiny, they are not as creamy as some of Divina, for instance. Extremely creamy eyeshadows, they don't last as long on me as these do, and I think they are stunning. I do have two comparisons for you guys, because I thought, let me pull them as well. So I actually pulled the Iceland palette and I pulled the Haunted Europe palette to, well, kind of show you side by side. So let's start with the Iceland versus the newer one. So here they are. This one is the Iceland palette, and the other one is the Whistler palette. They work very, very well together. There are no dupe shades. It may seem like it, but there isn't. I can kind of swatch compare. Let's see, the shade Hell, because we have a red. And then the shade Up to Snow Good. Yeah, so I have them here. So this is Hell. And this is Up to Snow Good. So you can see that one is more, Hell is more of a yellowy red almost. And this is more of a, it almost turns a little bit purple, at least on me. The one I also will compare swatch is the shade Whistler to the shade Elves. So here is Elves and here's Whistler. So Elves and Whistler. And I think that was kind of it. Yeah, what I can do is, oh, I can put the shade Northern Lights there as well from the Iceland palette. And what I can do is I can kind of swatch the blues a little bit. So I have the shade Valkyrie from the Iceland palette. Then I have the shade Blackcomb and Ski Bum from the new palette. So let's start with a Valkyrie. Then let's put this one next to it. And then this one. So this shade is shade Valkyrie from the Iceland palette. Then we get the shade Ski Bum, which is then the duochrome from the new palette. And here is the shade Blackcomb from the new palette. So that's the difference. And for the rest, yeah, that's it for these two palettes. So let's then grab the next palette that I want to compare, which is the Haunted Europe. Okay, let's start with the goldeny. So I have here Boogeyman and Huska Castle against Berry Cole from the new palette. So let me swatch them here. So this is, so here are all the golds, and the bottom one is the new palette. So there is a difference in, I hope it almost looks like this one, the new one, is a combination between these two. If that makes any sense. Okay. And I will show them in a little bit darker light in a minute. Let's next go to the greens then, because I also have a few greens. I'm concentrating on the shimmers first. So here we have the green shimmer. So the top two again are from the Haunted Castle or the Haunted Europe, and the bottom one is Shade Whistler. And there's just such a difference in tone. I can also grab the green matte called Grendel and then Bucking Great. So the Haunted Europe palette, I can also feel the difference, especially in matte formula from the Haunted Europe, which is a little bit more like their older formula. And then this one, it swatches like a pigment. So that means that the swatches aren't great because of the pigmentation. So the top green matte, this one is the Haunted Europe, and this one is the new palette. But you have seen how this one performs on the eye already. So swatches here is purely for color, because yeah, honestly, it swatches like a pigment. So I have, yeah, Bloody Mary and Up to Snow Good. So those are the two reds. Yeah, let me get For Fox's Sake against, I think, Spandau Citadel. I think that's the closest match. So here we have Haunted Europe, and here we have the new palette. And the last thing that I kind of want to swatch is the brown. So Drachsholm Castle against Gone Skiing. I don't know if I can still fit it. I will put it on my hand. Oh, this is fun to see. So Drachsholm Castle, which is this one, is a more cool toned one than the new one. Can you see that this one is turning very gray on me? That means that it's a cool toned brown, because that's what they do. And this is a warmer tone brown, and it stays kind of true to the color. So yeah, those were the swatching comparisons, I think. So there are no true dupes. They don't dupe themselves. It may look like it, especially in this palette, but there are none. I can, for reference, put the shade Hell. There you can see it. So here. Yes, and then what else did I have? The shade Elves and Northern Lights there. And this is kind of it. So here I pulled three shimmers at least from the other palette, and then you can see that there is not. Yeah, they're quite different. The closest that you get is basically here in the Goldenies, but still it's different. Let's just, for reference, also grab this one. It's not a dupe at all. The shadows are more vibrant. No duochromes. And the black in this one is not as good, in my opinion, as this black is. I feel that the black in this palette is, in their Christmas palette, is a little bit drier. I prefer the black in this palette. But yeah, if you have a black, you have a black, right? So this palette will be permanent, and I do think it is worth its money. Again, this is a palette that I would have bought myself if I did not get it in PR. And yeah, with then the shipping and probably the import, it gets a lot more expensive. But because I love the brand so much and I love this color story so much, I would have done it anyway. But that is me. I cannot check your wallet. I can only tell you that I think that the price that it retails for is valid. I do have an affiliate code that will save you 10%. So it makes it a little bit cheaper. But still, I think it's worth it. And I will leave down below their site. It will launch the 25th of January. So I cannot link the palette just yet. Yeah, I hope that my review was helpful. I hope that the tips and tricks that I gave you help you. And let me know down below your thoughts. The video from yesterday is linked underneath the card and in the description box. And on the end screen, I will leave my Nomad Cosmetics playlist. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys. Thank you.